This is the Synology DS918 Plus. It's a 4-bay NAS, but with some special features like 2 M.2 SSD slots for caching. Stick around to watch me unbox this and also give it a good review. It's Tech Quiz time. Hey guys, Jonathan here with Tech Quiz Time, where I do technology tutorial and review videos. In this video, I'm going to be looking at the Synology DS918 Plus. But first, let's get unboxing. So I'll push the box to the side. Here we've got our power cable. And in this box here, got a quick installation guide, 2 Ethernet cables, some keys for the locks, some extra screws, and a power brick, rated at 12 volts, 8.33 amps. And now for the main event. Ooh, that's a little bit lighter than I thought. And there we go, the Synology DS918 Plus. So on the front here, we've got the 4 drive bays, a power button, USB 3, and status LED lights for all 4 discs. On the back, we've got 2 fans, Kensington lock, USB 3 port, 2 gigabit LAN ports, an eSATA port, and the power port. Then flipping it over, we've got covers for the 2 M.2 SATA drives. Very quick and simple to install. And another thing, they are labeled too, so number 1 and number 2, which is really handy. So let's talk specs. So the DS918 Plus comes with a quad-core 1.5 gigahertz CPU inside, which can burst up to 2.3 gigahertz. As shown before, it's got dual gigabit LAN ports, and also comes with 4 gigabytes of DDR3 LRAM, which can be upgraded to 8 gigabytes. So this is really important when you're looking for, say, the Virtual Machine Manager package, as you'll need to allocate RAM to each virtual machine that you have. So there'll be a link down below where you can upgrade this to 8 gigabytes of RAM, or where you can purchase additional RAM, I should say. So because this is the Plus model as well, this actually comes with an x86 CPU instead of an ARM-based CPU, which is why you can use the Virtual Machine Manager package with this. So if it's something you think is going to be helpful in your circumstances, then definitely this is one for you. So if you're already familiar with the Synology DisStation Manager, then you'll know what this is going to look like straight out of the box. This is one of the things that attracts me to the Synology products, is their easy to use interface. The ability to install additional packages to get more out of your Synology NAS is so simple. Just a matter of searching for what you want, say for example Plex, installing it, and away you go. How awesome is that? Having USB 3 on the front and on the rear is great if you need to transfer files from, say, a hard drive or a USB stick, which is really simple to do. You basically plug it in and it mounts into the system, which is really great for, say, photographers or people that work on big files that need to transfer them from one place to another. So when it comes down to it though, the Synology DS918 Plus, I think, is more aimed at small to medium businesses rather than the home user. But it's not saying the home user wouldn't benefit from something like this. So as with any Synology NAS, or any NAS in that case, it's always recommended that you go for the NAS-specific drives, such as the Seagate Iron Wolf or the Western Digital Red hard drives. Using consumer-based drives is a gamble, so if you are looking to store your data safely and securely, then I highly recommend looking at either Seagate or Western Digital's NAS-based products. Well, that's it for another video. I really hope you liked it. If you've got any Synology-based tutorials that you'd like me to do for this channel, then leave me a comment down below, especially to do with this unit here in particular. If you're not a subscriber and you want to see more Synology videos, then make sure you hit that big red subscribe button. And if you are a subscriber, then make sure you hit that bell icon too, so you get notified whenever I release new videos. If you can do me a favor and like and share this video with as many people as you can, that would be fantastic. And as always, imagine, learn, create.